my presentation on religion and identity, which is kind of weird because personally I'm not religious. I was born and raised atheist.
Yeah.
You know, but growing up all my friends were like super religious and like they always had this cool community and like group of friends that I was a part of, and I was like, hey, that's pretty neat.
Well, that's like...
So a little bit later here I am giving my presentation on religion and how that fits identity and community. So like during my research I found out that religion and identity are like kind of go hand in hand, actually. Like when you look at somebody's identity, like religion's usually a really big part of that. Then you look at religion, and then like everybody like has a community identity as that religion, and it's like, pretty cool how that like can't really one without the other. Yeah, it's nice. So going way back, you know, there's the Aztecs, and you go a little bit forward, and you know, Bible study. I mean, like it's not really the same thing. But like, when you look at it, it's kind of the same thing, you know? Like, I mean, way back then, you know, you have this whole big party at like the temple or whatever, you know, everybody's drunk, you see all your neighbors, you know? Some dude gets his heart chopped down and kicked downstairs, you know, it's a great time. And then like, fast forward a little bit, you know, go to church, you got Bible study, or like some kid in the community is getting baptized, you know? Your aunt's probably still drunk, you know? Value of everybody coming together and like doing something cool. Yeah. You're all getting together as like a thing, and like y'all relate to it, and it's just like it's like something that your culture like embraces, and that's like kind of how religion gets that. It just stands the test of time. It's very nice. So the other part of that though is like how since culture's identity is like really brought together and like summated in religion. You know, it's a great way to like keep the traditions going through generations and like pass down like all the different like traditions to like the next generations. So what happens in a lot of cultures is like you're born and raised one way, you stay that way, you die that way, you raise your kids that way, not in that order. Like this big cycle that just keeps going through the generations and keeps like what could be a centuries old tradition keeps it going. So yeah. So the big questions. you know, bringing it like a little bit more central to like youth and like adolescence and like the whole who am I thing. You know, it's a great way for like going back to like the continuation of traditions and stuff from before, like where it's just like handed down from generations. Like a lot of the ways that like a lot of cultures deal with these questions that their youth have is they just like point them at religion, like, hey, this answers your question, you know, find meaning in it. And so they grow up in that way, have their own faith. And,